Very glad to have Leif Edmunds here to show us, to tell us his story and the new skin story. All right? And believe it or not, he's got how many grandchildren?
Four and a half.
I'll let you guys judge whether he looks like a grandpa.
No.
Okay? Come on up. And Sheryl, too. Let's see. Welcome, Grandma. Grandpa and this is Grandma. You guys believe that?
No.
Four grandchildren, no less.
Four and a half.
Very, very jealous. We only have two. Okay, let's welcome Lee.
Yay!
Hello.
Okay. Well, thank you for welcoming us here today. We're so excited to be here. We actually, our son plays basketball down in Southern Virginia, so we made this trip. We planned a few months out to come back here, so we get to see three games. We saw a game last Saturday, and we get to see one on Wednesday, and one next Saturday, and so we decided, well, let's go see Washington, D.C. And I asked, I was talking to Wynn Rosencrantz, and I said, is there a meeting that goes on in Washington, D.C.? He said, yeah, the Suns have a meeting there in their group, and you should go to that meeting. I go, okay, great. And then I got a call from Marguerite saying, Leif, I understand that you're speaking at our meeting that we have.
Yeah.
So this is how they've been so successful in the business, right? It's the power of persuasion, right? So we're really excited to be here. And I'm going to tell my story, but also tell, like Pat said, the New Skin story. We're honored to be here in what we consider New Skin royalty with the Suns and with all of you tonight. Before I start, I'd like to invite my wife, Sheryl, to come up and tell a few minutes about her story in New Skin. And we're so excited now. Well, I won't say anything more because I don't want to steal anything from her. So, Sheryl, why don't you come on?
I'm super excited to be here with Leif. Like he said, we are, I'll tell you our story. So we've been in the business about 14 years now, and I've been like a support to him. And I've been using the products, and he would call me his billboard. You know, he'd say, look at my wife. And I faithfully used the products and talked about them to everybody. But I kind of did a support to him. And I was home with our kids, and it allowed us to, I went to everything, you know, and I let him do the business, and I went to everything. Well, a few months ago, we dropped our baby off. We have five kids. Three are married and two in college, and one we're visiting now. But the baby we took to college in August, and we dropped him off, and I was like, now what? Who am I? What's my goal? Anyway, and he said, this is our time. You know, we've always wanted to do the business together. Let's do it. So I jumped in with both feet, and we're so excited to be together now doing the business. And now we're living the dream, the New Skin dream. That's my story. I'm happy to be here. Thank you.
That was her first time speaking in a New Skin meeting. How did she do?
She did great.
Wow.
I didn't notice.
That's good, right? Well, I put a few extra slides in. This is not the normal presentation, so I put a few of our slides in because we don't get out here that often, so I figured I'd share a few things with you. Now, you guys know what 2017 is, right? Right? It's the year of the chicken, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. We know that now.
But it's also the year of Leif and Sheryl because I was 20.
Oh,
And she was 17 when we met in Hawaii.
Wow.
Right, so 2017 is the year of Leif and Sheryl. So this was when we were 20 and 17. You can see I had like hair here and hair all the way across. I had a unibrow, they call it, right up here. Right, so I got rid of that part in the middle. I learned how to do that. But
cool.
Now it's turned into this. So this is most of our kids here. There's some that aren't quite showing in the picture, and these are the four grandkids. And this guy, Eli, he lives in Connecticut. He just had slapped her in the face. That's why we got them these pajamas that all match, right? So we wanted the picture with all the pajamas. He slaps her in the face. Her older brother, Emmett, is just getting a kick out. He's just laughing, oh, this is a great thing. This guy's only 4 months old. He's just like, what's going on here? I don't know. So now he's going to have a little sister. So she's the next one on the way. And for, you know, anyone who's a grandparent, grandkids are way better than kids.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
It's like the reward for dealing with your kids. You get these grandkids, right? So we love it. So that's a little bit about us. And I don't think she looks 50. Do you think she looks 50?
No.
No.
So you can use her picture whenever you want. She's a 50-year-old grandma from New Skin, okay? You can use that picture anytime you want. Now, let's talk about the business. I'll tell you a little bit about my story. So 14 years ago, we were in a situation where I had gone through school. I'd gotten my master's degree, a bachelor's in accounting and a master's degree in information systems. And I went through, I worked with a company called Ernst & Young for 5 years, and then I worked with other software companies for about 10 years. The last 5 years, I was the vice president of Latin America for a British company. So my boss lived in England, and I lived in Utah, and I covered all of Latin America. And so we worked through partners, actually. So it was distributors, but not in a New Skin sense. Our distributors were companies, smaller companies that would resell our software. But I built up a $5 million pipeline throughout Latin America for my company. And things were a little rough. It was 2002, right after 9/11 and things. Things were a little rough in the high-tech and the software industry. And we had four rounds of layoffs. And in the fourth round, people in a boardroom in England made a decision that they were going to pull out of Latin America. And that was, I got the phone call. And never had happened before. I'd been a top achiever with the company, with all the companies I worked with. But I received a call, and they said, you know, we really like you a lot. We had been on these success trips, kind of like what we have here. We'd have yearly trips there with the owners of the company and everything. They knew our family. They knew about our children and everything. They liked us. It wasn't about them liking us or not. It was about a tough decision they had to make. They gave me a 90-day severance, which was half just my salary, not my commission. So it was about a 45-day compensation, they said. For the 5 years you spent here, for the $5 million distribution channel that you built up for us, that they owned, they said, here's your 45 days. And that was terrible. And they said that's the most we've ever given an American. So it was like a record, you know, I was supposed to be excited about it. And it was tough. You know, that was the first time that it happened to me, and I had a sick feeling inside of my gut here. I was wondering what could I have done differently to not have this had happened to my family. I felt like I let Sheryl and my kids down. And 45 days, we weren't prepared. I don't know about any of you, but financially, I found that whatever we were making for the 15 years I was working in corporate America, whatever we were making from where we started, you know, $30,000 a year or whatever it was to where we finished, we always spent just a little bit more than we were making. Anybody know any? You guys don't do that, but you may know people like that, right? Okay, that's how we were. And so when I got that 45-day notice, we weren't prepared. Now, one thing that we have in our neighborhood that most people don't have, we had two multimillionaire distributors from New Skin. Anybody else have that in their neighborhood? So we had seen the end result before we started. You know, sometimes people wonder, does this really work? Is it really true how this works and everything else? No, we didn't even know what New Skin was, and we saw their lifestyles. So we knew it happened for them, at least. And then one of them talked to me about the business. And so we thought about it. You know, I went to a few meetings. It was right before an international convention, right before 6 months before the biophotonic scanner was going to be launched for the first time. That's when we heard about the business. We went to this convention. It was crazy. Everything that I was used to was all negative, down, and these guys were just cheering and happy and going crazy and growth in the throughout the world. And I was like, what? This is really strange compared to what I'm used to, you know. And still, we didn't know really. I didn't know if I could or wanted to do it. I don't know if you understand what I'm saying. I could see the company was going to grow. I understood what that biophotonic scanner was going to do. It was going to change a $24 billion nutritional industry that wasn't regulated. I could get the story. I just know if I could go from, you know, selling large process automation computer systems to talking to my friends about vitamins. Okay, that's kind of what I was wrestling with, and it was out of the box for me. But I also knew I didn't want to just return to this lifestyle number one here. Okay, we talk about lifestyle one and lifestyle two. I thought when I started, my dad, he worked maintenance all his life. And he said, get an education. So I did, and I went straight through and got my master's because I didn't want to go back to any more education. Okay, so I did that, and I started working, and I figured, you know, if I do really well, maybe about 60 or so, I could retire, and everything would be great. You know, I'll go play golf or go to the beach or do whatever retired people do. I'm not sure, okay? So that's what I figured I might do, okay? The problem with this is that even if you can retire, let's say at 65 nowadays, you know, things have changed, right? Do you agree things have changed? Mm-hmm. Even if you can retire at 65, then it only gives you 5 years, because we know at 70 it's pretty much the end, right? I mean, it's
Hey.
I did not make this slide, okay? This is not my slide, and I don't agree with that, okay? That's why I was making the joke. But at any rate, you know, you don't want to work for someone your whole life and then try to be able to live life on your own terms just at the end. Maybe if you can. The other problem with this lifestyle number one nowadays is we know that 2/3 of the population in the United States, and it's worse in most countries around the world, 2/3 of people don't have what it takes. 2/3 of people over 50 years old don't have money to retire. Do you know anyone like that? You don't raise your hands, but you know people like that, right? Okay, so what they're saying is they think they're going to have to work the rest, in some form, the rest of their life. So this lifestyle one that used to be okay is now not even real. Okay, so you got to find something else. That's what this lifestyle two comes in and says, okay, you're going to acquire your skills, you're going to work really hard, but at some point, you work smart, right? Where it's not all about you. Okay, and that's what my two multimillionaire neighbors had shown us, that it wasn't all about them. For some reason, they seemed to have money and time, and they were able to do whatever they wanted to do when they wanted to do it. And we didn't. Okay? So, we figured out if we could work really smart and hard at the same time for a period of time, whatever that might be, then we could enjoy and really live life on our terms the rest of our life. Okay? And you guys know people who are doing that, right? Okay? In this room, right? So, you know, that's all there for the taking right now. Okay, the tricky part is finding this vehicle that can provide that for you, because a lot of people work really hard, but they're in the wrong vehicle sometimes, right? Or even in our industry, they may be in the wrong company, and the company doesn't survive. Okay, so the tricky part is finding the right company and finding a growth window within that company, an opportunity when the company is going to go from small to big or from big to bigger. Okay, and that's what we saw. When we first started working with Nu Skin, Nu Skin was doing about $800 million a year in sales revenue. Okay, so it's grown 4 times since then. Okay, now we're saying we're going to grow 3 to 4 times more. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's what's going to happen now. Now, here's what we're going to talk about, these 5 points. And I've got a little something. I think it's a chicken because it's 2017. I got a chicken in my throat, so I'm just going to drink a little bit of water here. We're going to talk about these 5 points, the trends in the market, technology and products, the company, the compensation, and timing. Okay. First thing is trends in the market. This is really interesting. All four of these trends, I think these are pretty much the same. It just depends how old you are as to what you call it, right? Like if you're over 50, you call it anti-aging. If you're under 50, you call it health and wellness, but it's pretty much the same thing. So my wife and I call it anti-aging now, you know, but that's But anyway, it's the biggest trend we'll ever see maybe in our lifetimes. This is a huge trend, and we'll talk about the company, but how Nu Skin has positioned themselves in this entire opportunity in the past 32 years is incredible. Now, technology and communication. Now, we could probably ask Marguerite and Pat what their bills were like to be able to talk with people over the phone when they first started in the business. And they'd probably tell you thousands of dollars a month is what they would spend. Just 14 years ago, this is hard to believe, but just 14 years ago when we started, our way to provide a presentation, a standard presentation, was this thing called a VHS tape. I don't know if you've heard of a VHS tape. Okay.
Just threw them out.
It's like manual YouTube.
No.
Right? Okay. So we would take that tape and stick it in their VCR, and then we would sit down and draw the compensation plan. It was a videotape called Got Your Number. You know, it was Nathan Ricks talking.
Yeah, Got Your Number.
Oh, wow.
He was talking about the biophotonic scanner. He would say, once or twice in your life, you may come across something that can change the direction and the course of your life. You know, and he says, only once or twice. So, communication. I remember we had cell phones. I used to have two cell phones, one that had free nights and one that had free weekends. And it was crazy, you know. No smartphones, nothing. That's only 14 years ago. So I look back to people who did 20, 25 years ago with what they struggled with and how they mailed out VHS tapes around the world and around the country to do this business just to get a simple message across. You compare that with communication today, right? You can talk with anyone, anywhere in the world with WhatsApp or WeChat or whatever, right? How hard is it to share a video with someone? It's a little link that you text to someone or put on Facebook or whatever. Like, communication is incredible, that trend. Supplemental income, it goes back to that previous slide. Everyone's looking for ways to make money, okay? Everyone's looking for it. Now, we need to be able to present that in a manner that feeds into these different trends in the market. But like I said, Nu Skin, in this opportunity, it's like it's a perfect storm that's all come together at the perfect time with these trends in the market. Now, the company or the products and technologies we'll talk about first. This is the Innovation Center. How many people have been to the Provo Innovation Center? Okay, great, great. We live, see this mountain here? We live over that way about 15 miles, okay, right next to another mountain there. And this building is incredible. We love to get people into that building. We know that if we can fly people in from anywhere in the United States or anywhere from Latin America or Europe or Asia, wherever, and we can get them here, then they understand what this is all about. Okay? So, the scientists, we have over 70 PhD level scientists within Nu Skin that are on the payroll. You know, these aren't outside consultants that work when we need them or need a report or something like that. These are employees of Nu Skin. We've invested over $1.5 billion in research and development. Okay, so it's interesting, when I get on the phone with a new person and they think they know a lot about nutrition or skin, they're estheticians or whatever, and they start throwing out these questions, I don't know the answer to the questions, but I know I can get them on the phone with someone who does. Because I know this company has invested $1.5 billion in their research and development, and they have amazing products. Now, this is the facial spa, you know, we do half-face demonstrations with that. This is the third version of the scanner. The first one, I can tell you horror stories, right? We can tell you horror stories about how that scanner worked, okay? It was rough. Let's just say it was rough, but it was the only way to do it. Now, age lock means that any of our products, Nu Skin products that say age lock, means that we're working at the genetic level. We're resetting a person's genes to act the way they did when they were younger. See? Did you hear that? That was a key point in the presentation. Every time there's a key point, you'll hear that little chime right there. Okay, so age lock, you're going to see that throughout the presentation and throughout the Nu Skin catalog. And most of the new products that are coming out are age lock based, meaning whether it's a supplement you're taking or something you're using on the outside of your skin, it's resetting your genes to act the way they did when you were younger. Who doesn't want that? So, the AgeLock brand, it launched about 8 years ago, okay? It's now over a $5 billion brand, meaning in the past 8 years, just with the AgeLock product line, Nu Skin has sold over $5 billion of product sales, And these are wholesale numbers. These are not retail numbers. These are wholesale numbers that Edmunds contracts. Okay, so you can see we've had a couple different versions of the spas for the face, for the body, the transformation. That was a crazy launch. This R squared, the TR90. We have this AgeLock Me that we're going to talk about. We have AgeLock Youth. This, I think this is the next slide here. Yeah. This is just in the past, really 7 or 8 years, the AgeLock product pipeline. And I can look back at each one of these and remember the impact that each one of these launches had on my business. Because what we do in this business, we started with the biophotonic scan. Okay, and we had that scanner, we had the story of the scanner, it was going to launch in 6 months. We built up our team as big as we could before the launch, and we built it up, and we built our business to a certain level with the scanner. Okay, and that was an important one, right? Whenever you hear that chime, it is an important point. Remember that, okay? We built it up to a certain level with the scanner. And then we launched, we had Leif back already. I think it was G3 was next, you know, and then we built it bigger. So we had a base and we built on top of that. We built it bigger with G3. Then I think we launched Leif Pack Nano maybe, and we built it bigger with Leif Pack Nano. And with every one of these product launches, we were able to use the story of what that would do with your business and what the product would do for distributors and customers and build even more and more and more. Okay, that's what's incredible with this business. It renews the opportunity. I can look out in the industry and realize that other companies out there would love to have any one of these products in their product catalog. And they'd love to build an entire company around any one of these products. And we're spoiled rotten because we get a new incredible product every year, basically. This one, I think, is every year, basically. Right? This one, I think, is probably the best one we've ever had from a standpoint of building a customer base, building habits that people want to use our products on a daily morning, every morning, every night basis, okay? So, this is AgeLock Youth, and this came out just last year. Incredible. Again, it's AgeLock, so it's targeting thousands of youth gene clusters, they call them, throughout our body that deal with these different areas throughout our body. Basically, every aspect of health and wellness in our body, and it's saying these supplements, if you take 2 in the morning, 2 at night, will make all of these aspects of your body run better. Who would want that? Everyone. Okay, everyone. So this has been an incredible product. This is one of our top-selling products in the entire company right now. Okay, now, AgeLock Me. Okay, let's talk about this. This just launched the 10th of January. Okay, so we had some pre-launches going on where you had to have codes and stuff, but now it's out there and available. It's the very first personalized skincare system. Okay, now this is it. Okay, and what I do all the time is I just open this up and say, you know, what does that look like? You know, most people think it looks, there's cartridges. You know, I actually have cartridges in my bag here that I just carry around. It's kind of a conversation piece. Just that. You know, I may pull that and say, hey, what does that look like? They have no idea, right? They say it looks like printer cartridges or something. You go, yeah, I got to tell you about this. This is an incredible device. Okay, $40 million went into building this device. $40 million. It's the only device in a $400 billion skincare industry worldwide that is personalized, that is cartridge-based, and that people is habit-forming. Okay? It's incredible because we can show people, and I show this to people on FaceTime or if I'm live with them, I'll just pull this up on my phone and I'll say, yeah, go to this app here. It's called AgeLock Me. I'll say, you can even download this app and put it on your phone so you can check it out. You know, and it customizes 20 different characteristics about your skin. It takes that and puts it in a profile and gives a code to the company. And based on, you know, if you want the fully customized, which is $149 a month, or partially customized, which is $99 a month, it's customized to your skin. Even the $99 one is incredibly customized compared to anything you've ever had. And then this thing just sits on your countertop, okay? Is it okay? Whose is this?
Mine.
Is it okay if I mess it a little bit? Okay. All right, so you got these cartridges, right? Put them in here. It sits on your countertop. I'm not gonna use it, but I'm just gonna... And it'll do this. at you. See that one? It's blinking like that? See the little Hedgehog sign is blinking? Okay, it's important that it blinks. It really is. You're doing really well with those chimes. Because basically this sits in your bathroom counter and just blinks at you every morning and every night. Okay? Now who wouldn't want to have a product that sits in your customer or distributor's bathrooms every night and every morning telling them to use it. Basically when I see that blinking, I think it said use me.
Yeah.
Okay? So I'm gonna back out so we don't dispense any cream right now. But it's incredible. The AgeLock Me, I believe, is the best customer acquisition and retention tool that we've ever had in Nu Skin. Okay? The facial spa, incredible. But you only have to use that normally 2 to 3 times a week. And lots of times what happens, people start looking better, and what do?
They don't use it.
They stop using it, right? Because, well, I'm looking good, you know, I'm looking good now, and they stop using it. And then one day they wake up a few months later and go, oh, I better start using that again, but they haven't used it for a few months. Okay, this thing sits on your counter and reminds you, use me. And it's personalized, okay? If you've ever had anything customized or personalized to your own liking, it's very hard to go back to generic stuff, okay? To stuff that's not customized to you. Okay, have you ever had any clothes tailored or anything personalized yourself? Even a hamburger at McDonald's, right? They personalize it now. So it's hard to go back to the unpersonalized version. Okay, whatever it is. So there's so much about this device that is incredible. And it's just barely launched. Okay? This is how it works. We talked a little bit about that. You get your code, everyone's different. You know, it's easy to share this too. Right, there's a few 2, 3, 1.5 minute videos you can just text over to someone. Check this out and let me know if you'd like to have a half-face demonstration. Okay, we can do half-face demonstrations and show results in about 5 minutes. Okay, then they feel the difference the rest of the day. It's incredible. We compare it to other, this business model has been proven before. So the whole cartridge-based business model, you know, was proven with inkjet printers. Okay, it was proven with Keurig coffee makers or Nespresso, okay, where people buy the device and then they get hooked and they have to buy the cartridges month after month after month after month. Okay, what better way to ensure the longevity of your Nu Skin business? I don't think there's ever been a better way. Okay, now, I will tell you, yeah, we'll talk about timing at the end, but you better be out there sharing this with people on a daily basis, okay? Because this has the potential to go mass market. I think this is really the first Nu Skin product that we can see going mass market. And you want those devices to be in your business, okay? The more the better. Now, the company. This is the Innovation Center from the front side here. Nu Skin's in 53 countries. 2015, $2.2 billion in sales. Okay, so just that is 3 times bigger than when I started. And that's what I was told, and now I'm being told that it's going to grow 3 times more to 10 billion. Okay, the Nu Skin is going to grow to 10 billion. Right, which boggles the imagination. Okay, with all the good, all the wealth that's been created, all the lifestyle, all the lives that have been changed through Nu Skin, at a $2.2 billion company, we're saying, the company's saying that's their goal, that we're going to multiply that by 4. Everything that Nu Skin's done for 32 years, we're going to multiply it by 4, probably in the next 5 to 7 years. Okay? What are you doing every day to make a difference for your business? Publicly traded in the New York Stock Exchange, over 30 years of success, many different awards the company has won. Here's the business model, right? There's Nu Skin, there's the consumers, whether they're retail or preferred customers or distributors. And then there's us. So all we do in the business is share a simple, compelling story on a daily basis. And the more you and your business, your organization, shares that simple story on a daily basis, the more you're going to benefit from it. That's the whole business right there. Okay, I'm sure there are people here that know a lot more about the product than I do. But I know enough to use it, and I know enough to tell a simple story. Okay? that's all you have to do. The group that shares that story more than anyone else is going to benefit more than anyone else. Here are the average incomes for 2015. So you can see the monthly numbers and the annual numbers here. Now you see here it says EX. EX is the first level of leadership within the New Skin Compensation Plan. So that means you've done your first $4,500 basically of volume, purchasing and sales volume. Excuse me. These are the annual numbers. So the goal here, I've got a cough drop. My wife has a cough drop. I can feel it. That's a chime. That's a chime right there. So, these 1, 2, 4, 6, 8, 12. Thank you, Sheryl. That was her first giving of a cough drop in a New Skin meeting, right there. First time ever. There's a lot of firsts happening tonight, right? Okay? So, what we're showing here is if you are an executive and you have one executive on your front level, yours is called Gold Executive, and you can see the average incomes for a Gold. Two is Lapis, you can see the average incomes. Four is really important, okay, because that's where you start making more money. These are the real average incomes. And it's also where you earn your first success trip. And I see on the wall here we have Panama, and we have the next one we're qualifying for right now, which is Iceland. Okay, anyone who gets here, if you haven't been on a trip yet, anyone who gets here and maintains it for a few months, okay, by March 31st, will earn their trip to Iceland. Who's been to Iceland here? You have?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Great.
It's a beautiful country. I'd go back in a heartbeat.
Well,
no,
it's better go back for free, right? It's for any of these success trips. New Skin's gone now to Panama. They're going to Panama. Going to Iceland, Hawaii a couple of times. And these aren't the big, big trips. These are just trips that we can earn every 6 months. Disney World, Punta Cana in the Dominican Republic, Bermuda, Caribbean cruise, an Alaska cruise. Anybody, does this sound like good stuff to anyone? Mm-hmm. I mean, you can have free trips, basically a $10,000 trip every 6 months. Okay, it starts here, next one here, next one here, next one here. Did they have these when you guys started these trips, when you got to Ruby and...
No, nothing like that. Diamond, nothing.
Whatsoever.
Nothing. Yeah, until Timmy Lee.
Yeah. Well, you guys are really spoiled, right? I was minorly spoiled. We got a trip here, but this trip was amazing. It was to Utah.
Wow.
We had people who flew in from Germany, from all over the place, and they like picked us up in a car and took us up the 20 minutes up the canyon. When we got here, they gave us the fruit basket. Fruit of the month. Yeah. For 12 months straight we got a fruit. And I remember these pears, sometimes they show up like rotten already. It's like, oh, thanks Henry and David's or whatever it was. When we got here, they gave us a dinner, and you got to bring at least 8 people with you.
That's like, pretty good.
Okay, you guys get to go to Iceland, right? We got a dinner. And then this one was great. We got the Blue Diamond. They had a trip for Blue Diamonds, too. To Utah.
Oh, man.
It was Utah. Yeah. Actually, Utah, and then they drove us down to Las Vegas for 2 nights there. But it wasn't ice. It wasn't, what we had.
Man.
Do I sound bitter? I'm not bitter. I'm happy that we have this. It's really incredible that we have these incredible trips, like Iceland. Right? Now, this is crazy, really, that this company has created over 1,200 millionaires. And by the way, now, there's 3 multimillionaires from New Skin in our neighborhood. Okay, so we followed the pattern and it works. Okay, so that's a hint. Work the system, it works. Okay. But this is cool because every 3 days there's a new millionaire being created through New Skin. Okay? And it's going to go down, this is going to go down, and this is going to go up. Has to. Just the numbers are there. They're going to pay that out. So you want to be part of that. So, last point here is timing, and then I want to talk just a little bit about something called entry points. Okay, so timing. We talked a little bit about this, right? we've got a 5 to 7, maybe 10-year window right now, okay, where this company is going to go to $10 billion. In the United States, we believe it's going to go to a billion plus. There are companies out there much smaller than us who are doing $1 billion in North America.
Mm.
Okay? Nu Skin's going to do it. And I believe this is the launching point of us doing that. Because this takes down a lot of walls and perception that people may have. You can't find that anywhere else. Okay? It's incredible. Entry points. This is what I was taught early on. I was told there was these things called entry points. Because when I started the business 14 years ago, Nu Skin had been around about 16 or 18 years. Okay? So I live 15 minutes from Nu Skin. So everyone in Utah County around Nu Skin had heard about Nu Skin for 16 or 18 years. And when I would talk to people, they would say, Nu Skin, that's been around for 16 or 18 years. It's old, right? You need to find a new company. Okay? But what the millionaires told me, they said, no, no, no. There's entry points. There's points in time where it makes a difference, where you want to really invest your time. Okay? And there's reasons why. You know, maybe a new country opening. I participated in some of these new country openings in Latin America. It may be a new category launch or a new category builder or a combination of both of these. My opinion, this is a combination of both of these. Right? There's a new product and a new category builder because there's nothing like that in the world. Okay, so we look at Age Like Me. These are all the things that Age Like Me provides us. Okay? Someone else has invested $45 million in this. I mean, really, when you look at this, I mean, sometimes we take it for granted, but someone had to come up with this whole thing, you know, microlayering, the fact that they knew that three serums that couldn't coexist in the same tube together would have to be in three separate cartridges, and it'd be more powerful than anything out there, because if it was in three separate cartridges, you could have the full potency that would then be micro-layered onto your hands. And they took these three things and tried to just put them on your face. If you use this and micro-layer them on your fingers and then put it on your face, it's three times more absorbable in your skin. Okay, so this is incredible. If you look at this. And this stuff works. I mean, I've heard almost no complaints about it not working, where people said, my age, like me, it's pretty much idiot-proof. Anyone can take these cartridges out, put them in here, and work with it. That's what you want. You want something simple. You want something that there's demand. You want something that builds habits. Okay, that's what we have with this. It's so fortunate that we know about this. Okay? Now that's a new one. Okay. I remember when I started in the business, I saw a slide similar to this. Okay, and I think Nathan Ricks put it together, and it was about the scanner. And he said, not all time is created equally. And he showed me two triangles, this triangle and this triangle here, which may not look like it, but they're exactly the same size. This triangle here and this triangle here. And he says, you can start now and put this much effort in, and it's going to result in this much growth in your business for you and this much capture of a certain amount of the market for you. Okay? Or you can put the same exact amount of time in weeks, months, or years down the road. And you'll get some result, but it'll be something different because of the timing. Okay? The rest is lost opportunity, and it's lost to you. It's not lost to Nu Skin because someone else is going to do this if you don't do it. Okay, Nu Skin's going to go to $10 billion. All of us could leave out of this room tonight and never utter the word Nu Skin again. I don't see that happening, but we could. And Nu Skin's still going to go to $10 billion. Okay, so the question is, what are you willing to do to capture your part of that? Okay? You know, you may have heard, like if we say now, let's say a day today is worth maybe a week or a month, a year from now. That's how valuable it is, and that's what we're trying to show with this slider here. Now, you know, the timing, in my opinion, the timing's best it's ever been for Nu Skin. And it's kind of crazy. We have in our church, we go out and do visits once a month, and we have this retired doctor. He's 75, or probably 75 years old. So he's like 5 years past the end already, right? I'm just kidding on that. He's great. He's vibrant. He's a great guy. Okay, but he said he came over last Sunday, and he said, "Hey, I watched your video." I said, because he knows Jeff Mack, my sponsor, and we do some training sometimes on Thursday and on Facebook Live. He goes, "I watched your video." Now, I never asked him to watch my video, and he said, "I watched it from start to finish." He goes, "That device, I would use that. You know, I don't do skincare because I don't want to use all those bottles and everything. But you just stick your hand under there twice, that's all you do? I would use that." And I said, Great, Bruce, we can help you with that. No problem. He said, "What about my stepson? He just lost his job. Do you think there's really opportunity for him? Maybe he could do this." We said, "Absolutely there is." Sheryl went over the next day, did a demonstration on his wife on half her face. Okay? So I'm telling you, this is breaking down walls and barriers. The timing's right for new skin. Now, you gotta ask yourself, what does that mean for me? And I will tell you, it will never be convenient for you to prioritize new skin in your life. It just won't. For whatever reason, it doesn't work that way. Okay? But it doesn't matter. I was taught the business doesn't care about your own personal circumstances. It's unfortunate. It seems like that's a harsh statement, but it's true. The business doesn't care about whatever circumstances you're going through. It's going to go from 2.2 billion to 10 billion over the next 5 to 7 years, with or without you. So we all have to decide, okay, what does that mean? What am I going to do to take advantage of this window? Okay, and you can ask yourself some of these questions here, but the basic question is the time right for you, and what are you going to do about it? Now, just to finish up, here's how you get started. Right, and there's several options, and you can just sign up as a distributor, and there's no cost to be a new skin distributor. Okay, but we do recommend you get product, and there's certain starter kits that really help you get launched in the business. And you see, you know, we have the nutritional kit, the facial spa kit, weight management, product experience, and we have the AgeLock Me kit. Okay, they're all the same price. The best deal to do is if you do buy three, any of the three, you get one free. Okay, so I could buy three AgeLock Me's and get one free. I could buy one of each and an AgeLock. You can do whatever you want. You'll talk with your sponsor to determine what's best for you. Okay, but buy three, get one free, and that's going to start you off in the business. Start your qualification to become executive. Then you're going to help four other people do that over a period of time, and you're going to qualify for the next success trip. If you do that by the end of March this year, okay, which is about 60 days away, plenty of time to do it, you'll qualify for Iceland. The trip of a lifetime, really. I mean, most people won't be able to say, "Yeah, I've been to Iceland," unless you go with new skin. Okay? So you better do it. Now, that's really what we had to discuss tonight. And I would just leave you with a thought. I learned early on in the business that it's not about someone being an amazing public speaker or about someone, you know, who just knows so much about nutrition or so much about skin, they're an esthetician, whatever. It's not about them. It's about who's going to get out there and work. Okay, who's going to share a simple, compelling story with more people, duplicate that through their team, and have their organization sharing a simple story with more people. That's what it's about. So, you know, when we talk about glass ceilings or, you know, discrimination based on age or gender or race or whatever it may be in the workplace, there's none of that here at New Skin. The only discrimination is against those who don't work. Okay? Okay, you're discriminated against if you don't work from your commission standpoint. Okay, the harder you work, the more freedom and the more control you'll have over your life. Okay, now you take that with the timing that we have right now, and it's the perfect storm. And so instead of making excuses of why you can't work really hard right now, you gotta try to make excuses of why you have to work really hard right now, because that window won't always be there. I'm sure you can talk with Pat and Marguerite, they can tell you of windows they've seen, better and less windows. I've seen it in 14 years. Okay, I've seen it. We had a great window, and then it kind of leveled out for about 3 or 4 years before that facial spa came out. It kind of leveled out. All right, and it's no fun to work this business in a level period. You hope that you would have already built something. Okay, so don't waste good time in the business. That's what I would tell you. It can be the best thing you've ever done in your life. It has been for us. We love it. We're going to work really hard. We are working really hard. We'll continue to work really hard because this is the time right now. So thanks for having us here. We appreciate it. And you know, best of luck and best of success to all of you. Okay.
Now you heard his story. Right?
Can Sheryl share a story you shared at dinner? That was a great story. The one she shared at the dinner time, that when she went out, yeah?
And I was determined to talk to people and just share this amazing product that I love. And I came home after a couple of hours crying. And I cried to Leif and said, can't do this. He said, what are you afraid of? You know? And so I picked myself back up and I went out and I shared the story this last week with 15 different people doing demonstrations and he said to me before, you're not going to die from doing this. And I didn't. And I actually found that it gave me confidence because it is an amazing product. I mean, nobody has it. And so it just firmed up my belief in myself and in the product. And it was an amazing experience. And I loved it. And I'll keep doing it. Thank you. Thank you.
And I would love if you could show us how you do the demo.
Oh.
You know, with the makeup, you know, people with makeup on.
Sure.
And how they do it. And do we have somebody who wants to be a model tonight?
Yeah, you can do that.
Yeah. Okay. Turn your chair back. Turn your chair.
So, the great part about this is, like Leif said, you can put it on single dose. So if you have several people in a row that you want to do a demo on, you just put it on single dose.
Show them how to do that.
And so here it's, let's see, let me get it back to the beginning. So it says single dose right there. You scroll through the menu until you find that, and then you hit the check mark. And so you do that. And then this first bar here is for the serum. And so you'll check that. And then it will flash, and you'll tell the person to stick their hand under there and get the serum. Now, what you want to have them do is always do the right side of their face. And gravity works against us and pulls everything down. So when you're doing the demo, make sure you're lifting up. So you can, like, use your other hand and tap it around your face, just kind of draw a line, and then show them how you lift everything up. Like, I will show them beforehand how I do this on my neck, like this, always lifting. And then I'll take it and I'll go up and then around my eye, and I'll even hold it. Talks or any face lifts. And then on my forehead, I will do this. Kind of massage the wrinkles out and keep doing that over and over again. Good job. So as they're doing that part, I will tell them more about the business that Leif talked about. Like, show them the assessment on the phone, how they can fill it out, and then how there's a little less than 2,000 different yes that they can get together for their own skin. And then after, so normally you'll take a before picture too, which is super important, so that they can see the difference too, and you can show them, you can zoom in on their face on your phone too.
Thank you.
encourage them to do it for themselves. You don't do it for them.
I do encourage them to do it for themselves, mm-hmm. because then they can show people mm-hmm. and see how easy it is. Because if you do it for them, they may forget when they get home. How did I do that? Plus, they can duplicate it when they're showing other people too how to do the mm-hmm. demonstration.
Plus, you can do 3, 4, or 5 at a time.
That's true.
At the same time.
That's true.
The success, I'm going to have 4 people lined up there.
Yes.
And they're still single dose. And
yeah. So, yeah. And I did that the other day too, and it was powerful too, because they looked at each other's faces. It was super neat. So then I will hit it again and get it to single dose, and you just scroll through the arrows to find it. When you get to it, it's super simple. You just hit the scroll mark, and then you're going to want to just hit the arrow again. And it will take it to the middle one, which is going to be the moisturizer, and you'll hit check. And like Leif said, you can do this over and over again. You just hit back, check, and you can do several people at the same time. So it's flashing there. Mm-hmm. And then they'll just repeat the same thing.
For me, so is it going to sell?
Yes.
So just two creams.
Yeah. In fact, I'll show you.
It's one serum, one cream.
So you mean when you do demo, you let them use the serum plus the moisturizer too?
Yes. Yeah. And only on half their face.
Yes.
It's really important.
And the serum is 3 weeks of these 3 serums.
Yes. And then I like to talk about how sanitary it is. Mm-hmm. That you have all your jars and creams, and the second you open the lid, it's exposed to the air. And the second you put your hand in it, it becomes contaminated. And this is completely sanitary, and it's the first completely sanitary skincare system. And when you think about it like that, it almost makes you never want to go back to the to the jars and all the stuff that could be in there. And I also like to tell them that it's personalized for them. I mean, if you look next to you, does anybody in the room have the same skin as the person next to them? And there's different ages in the room too. Why would you want to buy the exact same serum or cream that the person next to you who has different skin type than you? So I love that it's customized that way. So that's how I do it. Any other questions on that?
Do you ever incorporate the pearls like right before the moisturizer, or talk about the pearls at all?
I have done that before, yes, using the pearls in between the serum and the moisturizer. Applying it the same exact way on the right side.
Mm-hmm. Can I make a comment?
Absolutely.
I think you're doing too much. A new person, really, the person who doesn't know skincare,
yeah.
She's going to be our makeup teacher next week. But when you do it to yourself a lot,
okay.
The regular people don't know that. Mm. So we need to have somebody who doesn't know how to put stuff on,
yeah.
to put it on and see the difference. Because you know what you're doing. People say, wow, I have to do that long.
Oh,
you see what I'm saying?
Good.
Before back, yeah. That was, do you agree with that?
Yes.
Can we
yes.
have another model who wants to go up?
Hey, look at her eyebrows.
Yeah, look at her eyebrows. It's all different. Her face all different.
Wow.
Face this way. This way. Yes. Oh, my God. Whoa.
That's a 5-minute demo.
Yeah, that was a really quick.
Okay, hold on. I'm making the picture bigger now. Oh my gosh, so different.
You can do this over makeup too.
Wow.
You don't have to have them wash off their makeup.
Take a picture.
Oh.
Yeah,
somebody
can
take a picture.
Need to take a picture?
No.
No, we need a camera. We have no.
Let me take you a picture.
Anybody else want to go up and try? Come on. Guys?
New one.
New person. We have a new person.
Do it.
We have that lady.
New person. Lita, can you have a new young lady here? Azam, we need your chair. Azam, we need your chair.
Hey,
you can
do two or three
together. Perfect. Okay, why don't we do two or three together?
Perfect.
I've done it before and then it was easier.
Yeah, Barbara.
Tommy.
Barbara. Huh? Why not? Do it. Come on, get your chair. Get your chair up so we'll have two, three people do it at the same time so we can watch it. Yeah?
You would do it to yourself.
I
do it
to myself. I know.
Yeah?
Yeah. Lita, you change the chair. Change chair with Barbara.
There you go.
So he's going to be on the voice. Move the chair around.
To your right side.
No, no, move your chair.
And go.
Barbara, turn the chair around.
Yeah. And remember to very gently swipe them. And she got that to work so well by just holding it a little. Yeah. Just gently.
Is that what about your daughter? Is she going
to
try?
Ask her if she wants to go, but someone
doesn't. No, it's okay. We have three people. That's what she's saying. You could do to exchange share with your mom.
No, no limits here.
No limits.
No limits.
Will you chair around?
Yeah. Yeah.
Right here. Okay, you sit here?
Yeah. That's it. Yep. And then up. Gently. All right, dear, you ready? Now that you've been forced up here, so that you see him, and then it's blinking at you. So to the right side of your face.
Okay.
Perfect.
So even if they have makeup on, all they do is just smooth on top of
it.
That's what I'm trying to get.
I didn't realize that. I thought you had clean first.
Your forehead.
No.
Right.
Just for demo. That's why it's amazing.
Right.
And then doing around your eye. Softly. Really soft. Yeah.
It's okay.
Perfect. Don't push hard, just really, really soft. That's perfect.
It's manageable. It's manageable.
It's not difficult. You don't have to be expert to do this.
No, at home I try to go behind my ears.
Sure, really soft. You ready for a moisturizer?
I'm not ready.
That's what I'm trying to show. It doesn't have to be that long.
Yeah.
I'm more than sure I require more time.
Okay. But this is for the thin face. Yeah. Do your
so
neck. Don't forget your neck.
Yeah, that was my question. This is for the whole face, but be using for half.
Ready?
Or better, yes.
Yes.
That's why it's too much, right?
Have you changed your teeth? Don't cheat. You do your neck, do your chest, or what do they call this? The
décolleté?
Décolleté.
The décolleté. Sounds like a chocolate.
Sort of
I know, it sounds like a chocolate.
Duet. Anybody?
You cough.
I owe you cream. I owe you syrup.
Yeah, scrape it off her face.
This is demo. It's costly, guys. You have to pay for the cream.
I'm gonna take it out of my eye. How about a Starbucks? I've already bought
it. Don't forget to do your necks.
Don't forget to do your necks.
If you look right here and forget about your neck, it really shows your age.
What shows your age?
Your neck.
Yes.
Forget to do your neck.
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
See, I don't have a mirror, so I'm doing.
No, we're not trying to get a mirror because if we're doing demo in front of for 5 people to 10 people, you got prepare 10 mirrors? No, no need.
That looks great. Yeah.
It's pretty relaxing here. It's heatless.
Yeah,
you guys are done. Look at this. What's this? Is this supposed to be a good
result? It could be your makeup.
Oh, it's just some of your makeup coming on. You look great. I mean, you're besides done without makeup now, looks better than your side with amazing makeup.
Yeah.
Much more radiant.
Yeah. You can tell from here, too.
Look at under her eye.
Yes. Yeah. On this side, you can see a shadow like this. This side, your right side is very nice and smooth. Amazing.
The facial, the mirror straight on. One thing I've noticed is that it also feels a little firmer. I use this every day, but
most people, on a good day, they're surprised about my age. You don't know how old you are. I love you dearly. Look at them straight on. Young girl, look at them right here. I mean, it works all ages.
That's what I want. That's what I want.
Right here, and then see here and here.
Yeah.
Her age. She looks amazing. Yes. Yeah. 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 Yeah
That I got from Singapore.
Oh, how wonderful.
It's cute. And then somebody has, I saw some on somebody's phone today. Is it Azam?
Oh, I love that.
So, and also, it's either California.
It's an icebreaker. Okay.
Love it.
Seriously,
like,
somebody would say, what's on this?
I called them, I said, need more. I'm glad you have any. So each single one, up. You see more, because I haven't even.
Yes.
I did not want to do my own. I didn't want to use it myself.
You wanted to do it?
No, I just want to show her. So open them like this.
Oh,
I think this is some here, what out there supply.
I know, I already sent them a note. I want whatever they have, I take them all. Your shipping is. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much. If anybody has any questions I want to ask, maybe Leif can give up because we had dinner with them and then it was Farah asked some good questions and Azam asked questions. It was really good. Lita asked questions and he helped resolve, and that's why I knew that Sheryl would, you know, do this. And I said, oh my God, this is really a nice. So I asked Lita, I said, do you have a machine? Who has a machine? We could bring it to demo because you can see it.
You know, that was I think to me this learn. I learn every time I attend the meeting, I learn. It's really, really good. Right?
One nasolabial. It looks better than the other.
Oh, okay. Well,
thank you for that.
You can see the face.
When one gets more mature, the nasal labial lines really.
Barbara, between you and Pat.
Yes.
Like he said, 70 gone.
Yeah.
The end. Remember you said that?
I know. How dare you?
I didn't get this much.
I know. 6 weeks.
Vicky is not here.
I know. I know.
Yeah.
After 69, you don't have to count. That's okay.
Yeah.
You better get 7.
And you know,
well, now you know what happens with empty nesters. You can travel together. We've been doing this. We travel together since what? 1996. After I retired from mobile. So we've been doing this for 22 years.
Wow.
So fun.
So I don't know if you ever noticed, wherever you go to convention, there's always four of us.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
Never one. So you guys can do that too.
Yeah.
You bring a very powerful team.
It's lots of fun to travel together. It's nice. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's lots of fun to travel together. So I was sharing with Sheryl. I didn't finish. I want to forget. So what I was sharing with Sheryl, the picture of a body spa, when I need to tell her what to do. Okay, Lita, you're gonna be my model. So what happens in the if you still have body spa with your friends, right?
Yeah.
Or you try to get some in Canada. However, so what happens? You ask a few friends together. So let's say it was me, Lita, Barbara,
Nikki,
and Farrell, right? So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there's 5 of us. So what happens, each one of us has a body spa. So we have Lita to unroll herself,
yes.
And we take a picture of the back. And then what we do is we split her back into 4. So I take care of one side for 10 minutes. So Barbara take care of this. She take care of this. And she take care of this. So we have some coffee, cookie, whatever, you know, stuff. Chit chat. For girls only. Well, I guess guys
can do that.
You're always together though.
I've been kicked out many times.
Yeah, but that's it. So then we just set 2 5-minute. So that's 10 minutes. And then after that, take picture. That's it. Then that's like for your figure. That's 10 minutes chit chat, 15 minutes, right?
Yeah.
Just rolling or whatever. That's about 30 minutes. So now we do her. We all zoom in on her.
Nice.
Then 30 minutes later, zoom in on her. Right. So all of the 5 of us is only like 2.5 hours.
Right.
Like
this.
Yeah, it's
before. I know.
Yeah.
Right.
And then maybe she happened to bring a new friend over. So new friend said she can't look. She can't look far, right? So she only looked
for it. Awesome.
Okay.
I like
so
that.
I figured you could do facial spa, same thing.
That's good.
Why not, right? So if you had a facial spa, you had a facial spa, you just do it, right? Why not?
Yeah.
No, but that is for new people. They should buy. So, 4 plus 1. Okay, so that's. Yeah, I was sharing with her some pictures. So I just.
Can I ask?
So, yes, sure. Questions.
Yeah.
Wanda.
Thank you so much for the question.
She's diamond.
I have a question. When you meet new people and you give a goal for them, could you please share to us what's goal? You know, like for the ruby. So you have something in the paper for them?
I don't know that I have a paper to share with you, but what I do is I tell them. Goals is very important, and I like them to spend some time thinking about them.
Oh, yeah, I need to
record. My phone is still here.
Oh, no, I'll be
you
there
can
here.
Come over here. You can take over now.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
So I think the goal is the most important thing. I always tell a new person that my role is to make sure that their level of commitment is in line with their goal. Okay? So if someone says, I want to get to Iceland by March 31st, and I can put 5 hours a week in, I'm going to say, no way, you're not going to make it. Right? Because 5 hours a week is not enough to make Ruby in 60 days. You can make Ruby in 60 days. You know, we have people make Ruby in 30 days. But New Skin is their life for 30 days, right? I mean, their job and New Skin is their life for 30 days. Okay, so when there's a new person, that's, for me, that's the most important thing, is that we are both aligned with their level of commitment and how fast they want to go. Okay, and if it's not Iceland, I say, well, let's just go, right? Because whatever you do, let's say you get two executives before March. Well, then you got two more that you just had to add two more on for the next trip, which is going to be incredible as well. But the most important thing is that the level of commitment is in line with the goal that they want. We have lots of people. I tell them talk is cheap, so I'll be really, really straight with them, right? Because it'll waste my time if I'm not. And it wastes their time, too. Oh, there's so many pictures. I don't know. So, you know, if I'll be really straight with them and say, you know, if for example, a lot of people look at those, the average incomes. They're not up there now, but I saw them up there, so I'm just pointing at the average incomes, and they'll say, yeah, I could replace my income with that emerald level, right? I could replace my income, or I want to make $45,000 a month. I want to be at the blue diamond level, okay? And I tell them, talk is cheap, right? It's easy. Everyone, if you just ask, hey, do you want to make extra money? Yeah. You know, would you like to make, you know, $40,000 a month? Yeah, I'll do it. Yeah, I'd do whatever it took. Yeah, I'd be willing to do whatever it took. But I don't believe words anymore, right? I believe actions. And so I'm trying to set the bar with them at the start to say, here's what you say you want. Your level of commitment has to be there. You have to say, first of all, your level of commitment is there. And then you have to back it up and show me that you want to do that. And then I tell them that I'll be right there with you running as fast as you're running for your business. I can't run faster for your business than you are. And I'm not going to babysit you and push you. You know? Because you should be talking with enough people that you don't have, that you just work with the people that rise to the top. And you're working with the people at whatever level they're working and engaged in their own business. As a sponsor, that's a thing I see all the time, is that someone may not have sponsored that many people, and they finally get someone in at the LOI level, and they go, yeah, I'm ready. I'm going to focus on this person and just, you know, sit on this one egg and hatch this one egg and get them to the Ruby trip, you know, get them to the success trip. And that never works, right? Because you can't... It's like we were talking the other day. Who was it? It was our daughter-in-law with our 5-month-old. And he was trying to do something, and his mom was helping him. I said, Ivory, let him crack the egg himself, you know? Let him crack the egg. You know, you can't weaken the eagle because they're chipping away at the egg for the eagle. It's the same thing with your new distributors. Be careful not to go into management mode if you're sponsoring people. It's very tempting to do that, especially if it's a relative or someone. You just want their success for them more than they want it themselves. They're going to do whatever they're going to do. And long term, you're creating leaders here. That's what you got to do. You got to create leaders. Okay, so I guess talk's cheap, and match their energy and make sure commitment is in line with what they say their goals are.
Can you ask a question?
No, that was it. Yeah.
For family members, let's say I see something. Let's say me, I want to teach my son how to do this business, and he's not picking up. He's not there yet, and I'm not. I am hearing you too. But let's say I'm ahead of him, and I find someone, I sponsor, and it works out, and my downline is doing well, and I sign him or her up under my son's name, you know, and then he gets the credits, and then to give him that push to move forward. is that the right? Is that managing for that?
By the way, her face, you can see it totally.
I know,
it
looks
like her face, right?
I was looking at it too.
Oh, yeah.
So with your question, that's all.
Did it make sense?
Yeah. That's always a temptation, especially when it's a loved one, right?
Yes.
But you can't want it for your son more than he wants it for himself. And you'll waste time. Until your son's ready, you'll waste time. And putting someone under your son isn't going to change it. It's going to spoil him.
Yes.
Okay, it's going to create a spoiled brat. Because this is like families, right? So if you put someone under your son, you get... When Sheryl came home crying that time, I said, hey, I've been there. I've cried. You know? You're earning your stripes. She had to earn her stripes, right? We were in the million-dollar circle. But that was mostly me with her support. Now, for her to go out and do it and do like what she did tonight was incredible. She had to cry and earn her stripes. So you can't earn your son's stripes for him by putting someone under him. Okay? And what happens is it will weaken him if he ever decides to do the business, because then he'll say, Mommy, I want another person. When it gets hard again, he'll come asking Mommy for it, right?
And then that downline will say, since you put me, why don't you find somebody put under me?
Yeah. Duplication. Everything duplicates.
Same thing with the downline. Let's say someone else is not your family member. So you don't want to really manage for them. You want to let them to manage the business.
You want to drive business underneath them, but with their contacts, not with you putting people underneath them. Bring me people, I'll help you. Let's get out your contact list. Let's make calls together with your contacts. But you don't want to give your contacts to someone else. You're spoiling. You're breaking the egg for them.
Yeah, sometimes you don't realize, but it's fear when you talk about this.
We're raising kids here.
Right, yes.
Right? It's a family. All the principles of family, of raising your kids, is the same thing here. And it's duplication, like Marguerite just said. You're teaching. They're watching you. If you're giving people to someone, other people are going to want people, and they're going to want people again. They got to earn their stripes. They got to cry a little bit. and then they're more powerful.
Yes.
My son went out and sold security or pest control this summer. After a week, you know, pest control, it's hard. You might not make a sale in two or three days without any sales. After a week, he was almost crying. But, you know, he stuck it out and he did pretty well this summer. So it's the same in life, you know, it's no different here.
It's a process of...
Yeah, you can't shortcut.
Thank you so much.
Any more questions?
So Sheryl, when you have a group of people, then one is very negative. So how do you handle that? Because there's always one person that, I didn't see it in me. It doesn't work.
Yeah, I've had that happen. You can always find positive in something. Always. Whether it's, if it's a demo and they're not seeing the difference, there's always something that you see that's better. It's either they're more hydrated or, you know, there's always a difference. They always look or feel better. Sometimes you feel better too, depending on your skin type. But as far as the business goes, don't listen to dream killers. Everybody has people in their lives that are dream killers, and you just can't listen to them. Just have a firm enough belief in yourself and a big enough why am I doing this that nobody can squash your dreams, because really the only one that can squash your dreams is you if you let people negatively affect you. That goes with every aspect of your life. Yeah.
That's true.
What do you...
Yeah, and I would say manage expectations from the start of the demonstration. You know, we've seen almost everyone had results here tonight, right? Yeah. But if you lower the expectations and you say, you know, everyone may not see dramatic results from this demonstration, but everyone's going to at least feel a difference from, you know, having this serum with the micro layering on half their skin and then having the night cream or the day cream on their skin. They're going to feel a difference. Everyone's going to feel it. And then when most people see a difference,
their expectations were lower, right? Sometimes we show them the most incredible pictures, and so that's where their expectations are. They're up here. Like, if I don't see this, you know, it's not good, right? So if we kind of lower the expectations, saying that most people will see something, everyone will feel something, you know, then that's better. But you always have that one person who's negative too sometimes, and you just have to, you know, smile politely and focus on the others, you know, so she or he doesn't drag them down a little bit, you know. So you just got to manage the crowd a little bit. First, manage the expectations, and then, you know, be kind and courteous, but don't try to spend the whole evening trying to satisfy the negative one, you know. Focus on the positive ones.
I actually had that happen to me once, and my friend did not see a difference, and I said, you keep watching your face and you concentrate on how it feels. And she woke up the next morning and her face looked different. I mean, it had settled in. I mean, everybody's skin's different. And she called me the next morning and said, I need to have this.
That
so
was the spa.
That was with the facial spa. She didn't see any difference that night, but she woke up with her face, one half of her face looking different. So I always tell people, you keep watching your skin and, you know, how you feel and how you look.
For that, I want to share, you know, I'm in that dance troupe, and there was one lady says, ooh, my husband is a doctor at GW. I want to see your spa. I'll come over to your house. So I actually did her face. She looks in the mirror. About the same. I'm thinking, four-letter word, okay? And I says, you see the difference? And Pat came down, and she didn't want me to take pictures, but I said, I'll take a picture with your own camera. You can see the difference. I'll go home and ask my husband. He's the doctor. He knows. Okay? She goes home. The next time I saw her in dance class, my husband just says, my face is more swollen. Okay, I'm never going to recruit her.
Yeah.
Yeah, just forget about her. Also, you know, so I concentrate on some other girls. So actually for this, you know, while we were doing the last day for preparing for two, I brought my makeup. But I know I'm not really a makeup artist. I can't say that, let me do makeup for you. So then I was doing my makeup and all that, and this, can you do me a room? So I did some, and the other girls, oh, it is so nice. So what I did is I did the new skin trick. I only do half a face. So I did a one, well, because Asian, we have smaller eyes. So I did the eyes. I said, look in the mirror. You like that? They're like, okay. Then I do a little bit more. So I finished the one eye. So she sees the difference. Then I do the other eye.
Smart.
Okay. And then naturally, the teacher is the one who does the finish. You know, she'll ask, she's, oh, it's not dark enough. We need to do more. more red on the cheek and all that stuff. But then, so there are three of them who wants to come and see me later. So I'm kind of, I call myself a little bit soft sell. So I don't push that hard, but I'll follow them for a long time so that eventually they come in. So yesterday I went to dinner. So I went, this guy who has a hand, they call a, what do you call it? The carpal tunnel syndrome. And I know the spa will help her. No, we have a doctor. So then they agreed to do it last night while we're meeting. They didn't show up. I said, okay, let him have the problem. Yeah, I mean, you know, if they don't show up, so I haven't sent them a text. Where were you last night? I'm trying to look for the picture that I found that used the body spa and then the upper hand using the facial spa. And the hand just, you know, the swell just went away. So I know it's good, it'll be good for the nerves. So for the facial, you can see the difference. What you have to do with the person, you have to clear the lymphatic drainage on the face first. So you use the wavy head, the blue gel, clear that face first, and then 100%. Okay, try it. When you go home, try it once.
Any more questions?
Technical questions.
What are you guys saying?
We're on the other side of D.C. in Clinton.
Clinton, Maryland.
Clinton.
Oh, that's far.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's closer to the basketball place?
No, it's just where I had Marriott there. There's a Marriott there. It's
there are many, many Marriott.
There's like hundreds of Marriott here. There's one up the street here.
I don't know the area. So.
It's okay. Well, next time, you should ask me.
I didn't know I was going to be the speaker.
Come stay with us next time.
We didn't know we have four Ritz-Carltons here.
Yeah, we just found out. Russ Collin came into town.
Yeah.
So I said, would you mind meeting with the distributors here? He goes, first he says, no, I'm not going to have time. But then he said, okay. So we set a date, set a time. So he said, I'm staying at Ritz-Carlton. So I said, okay, Ritz-Carlton. They probably went downtown. So I Googled and I found one on M Street or something. So I sent this, whatever, I sent to everybody here. It's a good thing. Lita said, are you sure it's that one? It's going to be people marching. There's not going to be. There's one in Georgetown. He must be staying in Georgetown. I said, nah. Is there one in Georgetown?